Gospel of October 27, 2015, a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said, "What is the kingdom of God like? To what can I compare it? It is like a mustard seed that a man took and planted in the garden. When it was fully grown, it became a large bush, and the birds of the sky dwelt in its branches." Again he said, "To what should I compare the kingdom of God? It is like yeast that a woman took and mixed in with 3 measures of wheat flour until the whole batch of dough was leavened." Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I am just going to dwell in this beautiful, beautiful gospel. The Lord is trying to teach us how is the kingdom of God. Now, it is not that the Lord is talking about the complete kingdom of God, because the kingdom of God would encompass the whole universe, so it is immense. But the Lord is talking about something very small, something that seemed to be almost unnoticeable or unimportant. He gives us 2 comparisons. The first one is a mustard seed. Back there and then, a mustard seed was the smallest seed available, something insignificant. And that is the way he wants to compare it. Because actually what Jesus today is talking about is the kingdom of God inside of you and inside of me. What is this comparison about this mustard seed? Mustard seed is the word of God, is the word, is the gospel, the word of the Lord. It appears to be just as any other word. There might even be some discourses that would be seemingly greater, more pompous, better prepared, lengthier, more beautiful in words, but they are nothing compared with this word of God, because the word of God is alive and has power, because it has been pronounced by the Father. The only begotten Son is the verb, is the Logos. It's only one word that the Lord our Father pronounced, that the God Almighty pronounced. So it is that word that seems to be insignificant, but yet contains the whole kingdom of God. Now, he says, a man took it and planted it in the garden. Who is that man? Certainly, we can think about the Father or the Son who has planted in the garden. That is the good soil of your heart and my heart. And when we talk about heart, we have to remind ourselves about the Semitic way or meaning of heart. That is our conscience. So when we receive the word, the eternal logos of the Father in our conscience, and then we let it grow, it will come to be a fully grown large bush where the birds of the sky will dwell. What does that mean? Again, it is an analogy. The birds of the sky means other people that will receive, that will be the beneficiaries, that will benefit from your transformation, from your growing into the faith and into the good deeds that eternal logos will produce in you and in me, hopefully. Again, the Lord speaks about the second comparison. Like yeast that a woman mixed in with 3 measures of wheat flour, and the whole batch of dough was leavened. Certainly we know how to leaven the dough through the yeast. But now, again, we have to remember it is a comparison. Each of us who are willing to become part of the family of God, the children of God, become like yeast, because we should grow and develop into the faith and good deeds in order that we might be able to make present the kingdom of God. But the kingdom of God has to start in our conscience, in our hearts, in our lives. It is from within that God will express himself through you and me in the world, and through our good actions, through our good deeds, through our loving and caring and prudent living. It is how we will make present the kingdom of God. If we do that, we will certainly, by the grace of God, be taken up to heaven when we finally are called to be upon his presence. May God bless us all, especially all of you brothers, that we might be truly like that good garden where the seed of the mustard is growing, like that good yeast that is transforming everyone who deals with us on a daily basis. Until we meet in heaven, God bless you all, brothers.